All right, it's Wednesday, April the 28th, 2010. This is your Daily Dose. Sorry we didn't get a chance to get anything up yesterday, but we were so on fire on Monday that, well, we had to make up for lost time yesterday, and we had a lot of big things happen yesterday behind the scenes that we had to take care of, so I apologize for no videos yesterday, but we're going to get right back on track today, and today I got something very important to talk about, something that I think everybody should educate themselves on, but we're going to start first with our quotes. And the quotes today, you're going to find a key word that runs through all of them. The first quote says, "Law and justice are not always the same." And that was from Gloria Steinem. The next quote says, "I'm for truth, no matter who tells it. I'm for justice, no matter who it's for or against." And that quote was from Malcolm X. The next quote says, "There is a higher court than courts of justice, and that is the court of conscience. It supersedes all other courts." We'll put a star by that one because we're going to talk about that one again. "At his best, man is the noblest of animals. Separated from law and justice, he is the worst." And that was from Aristotle. "What I am for is justice for everyone, just like it says in the Constitution." Wonder who that genius... Hey, that's a comedian. Richard Pryor said that one. And then last but not least, and this is the way I feel about medical cannabis, "I'm armed with more than complete steel, the justice of my quarrel." And that was from Christopher Marlowe. And those are your quotes for today. We'll be right back in a few minutes. I got a couple guests walking into the lobby. All right, got through the quotes, had a little interruption, had to help some clients there, but we're back. And what I wanted to talk about today is just a little information. Some more education and information, as we always do. Get that Sweet 420 shirt, holla. And what we want to let you know about is there's a website out there, and it's called the Fully Informed Jury Association. Because what I want to talk about, in the upcoming future, I'm sure that here in Nevada, we're going to run into some court cases, we're going to run into some trials, and I want to let people know what their rights are as jurors. This is something that I talked about way back when I first started doing videos. Matter of fact, it was one of the very first five things I talked about in videos, and I wanted to go back and reiterate on it. And when you go to this site, which is FIJA.org, and once again, that's basically the Fully Informed Jury Association, they have all kinds of things about what you as a juror, your rights, what you can and can't do, so on and so forth. And it talks about the power of the jury and what a jury's ultimate function is. And what I want to do is I want to read you something real quick. It says, "The primary function of the independent juror is not, as many think, to dispense punishment to fellow citizens accused of breaking various laws, but rather to protect fellow citizens from tyrannical abuses of power by government. The Constitution guarantees you the right to trial by jury. This means that the government must bring its case before a jury of the people. If government wants to deprive any person of life, liberty, or property, jurors can say no to government tyranny by refusing to convict." Now, let's read on. I have another little bit. This is all from this website. And it talks about, in November of 1734, a printer named John Peter Zenger was arrested for seditious libel against His Majesty's government. At that time, a law of the colony of New York forbid any publication without prior government approval. Freedom of the press was not enjoyed by the early colonialists. Zenger, however, defied this censorship and published articles strongly critical of the New York colonial rule. When brought to trial in August of 1735, Zenger admitted publishing the offending articles. Now, this is what's great. He admitted to publishing the articles, but argued that the truth of the facts stated justified their publication. In other words, because I'm telling the truth, I have to publish this. The judge instructed the jury that the truth is not justification for libel. Rather, truth makes the libel more vicious, for public unrest is more likely to follow true, rather than false claims of bad governance. And since the defendant had admitted to the fact of publication, only a question of law remained. Then, as now, the judge said the issue of law was for the court to determine, and he instructed the jury to find the defendant guilty. It only took 10 minutes for the jury to disregard the judge's instructions on the law and find Zenger not guilty. That is the power of the jury at work, the power to decide the issues of law under which the defendant is charged, as well as the facts. In our system of checks and balances, the jury is our final check, the people's last safeguard against unjust law and tyranny. Now, it says, but does the jury's power to veto bad laws exist under our Constitution? It certainly does. And I'll leave this for you to read it. And this is in the Juror's Handbook, a citizen's guide to jury duty. And this was written from somebody at Regent Law School in Virginia Beach, Virginia, a place I used to live, so I got love for Virginia Beach. But I would encourage you to get out to fija.org, because in the near future, one of you might be asked to sit on a jury, and they might ask you questions in regards to your beliefs on cannabis. Know this, if you're on a jury, and you're looking at somebody that is using cannabis, and they say they're doing it to treat medical purposes or for whatever reason, if there is nobody harmed, and the person is there and you believe, regardless of what the law says, remember from our quotes, I told you we would talk about those quotes again. I said, there is a higher court than the courts of justice, and that is the court of conscience. It supersedes all other courts. They can't hold your conscience against you, so if you vote your conscience on a jury, you can't be punished for it. So if marijuana should be legal, and in your conscience you know that it's harmless when regulated and controlled and when used responsibly by adults, the same way tobacco or alcohol or a fork or a knife or a jackhammer or a handsaw or anything else is used, then you have a responsibility, a conscience responsibility, to not convict. It's that simple. And that's what we want to get across to people. Jurors, you're the last stance. So when we have a state constitution in Nevada that says there should be appropriate methods of supply, and we have patients that get in trouble for trying to get access to this supply, know that if you're on that jury, do not convict. That's one example. There's other examples that we will come across, but I want to start preparing you because the battleground is set. It's coming soon in Nevada, whether people want to believe it or not, and we need to be ready. So this is first step in many, educate and inform. And there you go. Today was Wednesday. Hope everybody's having a great hump day, April the 28th, 2010. And this was your daily dose. We might do another one. We're not sure. So stay tuned. If we do, we will. It just depends on what I see throughout the course of the day. All right, everybody, have a great hump day and enjoy the rest of your week, and we'll see you tomorrow.